With Frieza heading toward their location and on the horizon, Vegeta does not think of his wish on the Dragon Balls. He does not think of helping out the Earthlings or his revenge on Frieza. He is thinking of one thing and one thing only, and that is to get Bulma out of Dodge, because Frieza will absolutely kill her.
Prepare yourself.
Subscribe and hit the notification bell to help us achieve the 300k mortal plan. Every soul counts. What's up, guys? We are on the newest chapter of Bulma and Vegeta Fall in Love on Planet Namek. I'm going to be reviewing this Dragon Ball fan manga by Queen of Fangs on Twitter. I'm gonna leave a link to her Twitter account again in the description below in the top comment. Always support the artist. And if you are not caught up to this chapter and you would like to relive the experience all over again, I'm gonna leave a link to the playlist, the entire playlist for this story, again in the description and the top comment. That way you guys are all caught up. Let's go ahead and jump right in. The events of the Dragon Ball Z anime slash manga basically went the exact same way. Gohan and Krillin found Dende and they stole the Dragon Ball, summoned the dragon to make their own wishes so Vegeta would not make his for eternal life. But instead of Vegeta flying toward the location where these dudes betrayed him, he instead thinks of only one thing, and that is Bulma. And as Purunga looks down on Gohan, Krillin, and Dende, Dende yells back to ask your wishes before Frieza comes. Obviously, they can all feel Frieza coming over the horizon. And as this is going on, Vegeta grabs Bulma and carries her away, running down the halls, looking frantically for something. Bulma yells frantically behind her, yelling at Vegeta, saying that she needs to help Goku. She needs to fix his tank, because if she doesn't, he will not be fully healed. But Vegeta says forget about Kakarot, because he is looking for something far more valuable. And as Vegeta kicks open walls looking for whatever he's looking for, he yells at Bulma that for the sake of the weaklings that betrayed him, one of the wishes that they're making better be his. He needs to run out the clock to get Bulma somewhere and at the same time get back to make his wish. And as Dende wishes Piccolo back to life, the events of the original timeline seem to be going smoothly. Honestly, I do like this wish a lot because it brings back the original Dragon Balls from Earth. But at the same time, I think that bringing Piccolo to the planet is a little bit of a wasted wish. Even though he does go toe-to-toe with Frieza for a time, it only buys them enough time to get Goku into the mix. And Piccolo, in my opinion, doesn't really make a difference after that. On King Kai's planet, Piccolo is finally revived as his halo disappears, and we get a glimpse of Bulma as she looks frantically at what Vegeta was looking for, and that is Frieza's own personal pod. Kami returns back to life, and Purunga tells them that their first wish has been granted. Now state your second wish. Bulma finally realizes what Vegeta has been doing this entire time, and she yells that she is not leaving. Obviously, she does not have the strength to fight off Vegeta. Vegeta is trying to save Bulma and get her away from the situation as far as possible, as far as she can go, because he knows that she can't do anything more here. She can't fight off Frieza. There's nothing that she can do to help. She'll just get in the way. And Bulma tries to pardon her friends, saying that they're just desperate. That's why they stole the Dragon Balls away from Vegeta, and that if they work together, they can defeat Frieza. And just because she's not powerful like Vegeta doesn't make her useless. Bulma is breaking down at this point, crying, because leaving leaves her friends behind and leaves Vegeta behind in the hands of a monster like Frieza, and there is no guarantee that any of them can defeat him, really. Honestly, nobody knew at this point that Super Saiyan was officially going to be a thing. Vegeta gets her attention by saying, "Woman, lend me some of that strength," and he grabs her, pulls Bulma in for a kiss. To her original surprise, but she ends up kissing him back. The kiss that has been built up throughout this entire manga thus far is finally happening. Their love on planet Namek. Of course, Vegeta made the first move, but it's not something that Bulma hasn't been thinking about since the very beginning. It's a very tender moment between the two because Vegeta knows he's saying goodbye. And the fact that Vegeta ends up really dying at the end of this whole thing and then coming back after, but we didn't know that part at that point. But yeah, he ends up dying on planet Namek. This moment is a lot more sad when you reflect on that. And the kiss was a sufficient enough distraction as he throws Bulma back in the pod, closing it as she bangs against the door. Vegeta smashes through the hole in the ship, making it larger, flying straight toward Krillin and Gohan as Krillin yells back, "Vegeta is coming," and they ask for Piccolo to be brought to planet Namek. The pod begins to levitate, obviously it's getting out of dodge, and Bulma keeps banging on the control panel trying to break out of her imprisonment. But Bulma has definitely gotten to the Saiyan Prince as he is trying to focus on his goals, and he can't because all he's thinking about is Bulma. But Vegeta's looking out for Bulma doesn't go anywhere as she accidentally opens up the pod, throwing her out of it. And now she is back in harm's way. Vegeta continues to fly toward the dragon because he needs to get to the brats to stop them before they use up all their wishes, as Purunga easily wishes Piccolo to planet Namek. They don't see Piccolo anywhere around, so they start yelling, same thing as the anime, and Dende's like, wait, you wanted to bring him here to this spot? Because he would have needed to be extremely specific to the dragon, and he was not. Bulma flings on the floor, obviously because of the fact that she just kind of tumbled out of the pod, and she is still going to be a major player in the story, but as she rolls, Vegeta finally lands on ground zero where Purunga is at. Similar to the anime, there is one wish left. Will Vegeta get eternal life in this version of the story? We will find out in the next chapter. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. Let's see who won, hashtag end of video squad. The winner of today's hashtag end of video squad, the soul that decided to stay till the very end of my previous video and drop hashtag end of video squad on their comment, is going to be Lazy Gaming Pug. The way they did Bulma is miles ahead the original. Can't wait to see what happens next. Yes, Bulma in the original Namek, she wasn't as feisty at all, like not even close. And she wasn't even like that much of an important character, essentially. Like, she kind of guarded the Dragon Ball for a long time and then was fucking around with Ginyu Frog, I guess, and that was basically it. She really wasn't very important in the story in the Namek arc, but in this story she acts way more like her Dragon Ball Super self. She's in the cut of it, she's more into the story, she's more integral into the story, and her love story with Vegeta definitely holds dear. I definitely love this story. I cannot wait to see where this manga is headed. Thank you so much for your comment, Lazy Gaming Pug. This is going to be Blackscape signing off. Take care, guys.
Subscribe for more content.